Good morning, friends. Today we continue with our chapter, that is chapter 11, mensuration. Yes, in this chapter so far we have studied the different three-dimensional objects. Okay, so we started with two-dimensional objects, that is the circle, the square, the rectangle, and from there we moved on to the three-dimensional solid objects. So we are done with the cuboid and the cube. In today's lecture, we are going to study the cylinder. Now observe the cylinder carefully. What is the difference between a cuboid, a cube and a cylinder? So you will say the basic difference is that the cuboid has got three dimensions, a length, a breadth, a length and a height. But all these edges are straight edges. Even a cube has got length, the breadth and the height. But all of them are equal. The length, the breadth and the height is all L. They all are equal. And these two figures, both of them, are made up of straight edges. Now when we move to the cylinder, we will see that in the cylinder, there are no straight edges. The top part is in the shape of a circle. The bottom is also in the shape of a circle. Yes. And there is a part curving around the cylinder. Now, the cylinder has got a curved part, while the cuboid and the cube had only straight edges. So today we are going to learn how to find out the lateral surface area. Lateral surface area is also the curved surface area of the cylinder, and the top and the bottom, which are flat parts. The circle at the top and the bottom are flat, but the lateral surface area is curved. So we move on to our first shape, which is having a curved surface. So how do we understand the cylinder? There are some figures given to you here. What they have done, they have taken a net, yes, made up of small centimeter squares, right? Then we can see the cylinder has got a certain height h. So this net is cut off at that height h. Exactly, you can see in the figure 2, the net is cut off exactly at the height h. And it is rolled around the cylinder till the two edges touch each other. Okay? Till the two edges touch each other. So this net is rolled. You have to keep on rolling it against the cylinder till both the surfaces touch each other. So once you get the measure, you can open this net. And what you will see, the net is now in the shape of a rectangle. You can try it at home. You can take a piece of paper and your water bottle and roll the piece of paper on your water bottle such that the edges touch each other. When you open the piece of paper, you will find it is in the shape of a rectangle. So here they have opened the cylinder to get a rectangle. You can see this netted part is opened up to form a rectangle, and this circle at the top and the bottom, what is this? Those are the circular edges which are on the top and at the bottom. So when a cylinder is opened, a cylinder is a three-dimensional object. When it is opened to make a two-dimensional object, you get a rectangle. This rectangle is the curved part of the cylinder. The top, which was flat as a circle, and the bottom, which was flat as a circle. We have to find out the curved surface area and the lateral surface area, or the curved surface area and the total surface area of the cylinder. So now we'll see how we can do that. What formula we are supposed to use to find out the area. So here we have a cylinder. So first let us understand the dimensions of the cylinder. The cylinder is a three-dimensional object. but it has got two dimensions here. The circle at the top has got a radius r. So the circle at the bottom has also got a radius r. To define a circle, because it is equidistant, we only take one dimension. Actually, the circle is a two-dimensional object, yes, but we need only one dimension, that is the radius, to find out the area of the circle. If we recall, what is the area of the circle? Do you remember the formula? Area of circle is equal to pi r square, pi into the radius square. What is the value of pi? We take the value of pi as 22 by 7 in most of the sums, or when specified we take it 3.14. Now you may recall the pi is introduced in all the places wherever there are curved surfaces. The pi has got a value in relation to curved surfaces. We have done in the previous lectures that pi is a ratio, which is the ratio of the circumference of the circle to the diameter of the circle. Now, since this ratio relates the circumference and the diameter is a straight edge, the circumference is a curved edge. So, in all the places where you will encounter curved surfaces, you will come across this value of pi, which you take as 22 by 7 or 3.14 depending upon the sum. Okay, again I make you recall that circle is a two-dimensional figure, yes, like a rectangle. A rectangle is a flat surface which has got length and breadth. A square is a flat surface whose length and breadth are equal, so we call it side of a square, S and S. They are two-dimensional. In the same way, a circle is also two-dimensional. But to find the area, we only need one dimension, R, because we have got this value of pi which relates the curved surface to the radius. So we have got the top and the bottom which are in the form of a circle, and the cylinder has also got a height h. So these are the dimensions we are going to use to solve the further sums. The cylinder has got a radius r and a height h. Now as you can see in the figure, with the help of a scissor we separate the parts of the cylinder. So the circle at the top is cut off, the circle at the bottom is cut off. So what are you left with now? A cylinder with no top and no bottom, a hollow cylinder, open from the top and open from the bottom. Now with a scissor you cut down one edge of the cylinder. So when you open up the edge, you will see a figure like this. The circle on the top is separate, the top, the circle at the bottom is separate, and this is the curved surface in the middle. Now when you open this curved surface, when you open it up, stretch up fully, you will get a rectangle. So the curved surface is in the form of a rectangle. Now what is the formula for area of a rectangle? We know it is length into breadth. Here you can see the breadth is equal to the height. When you open up, the breadth has turned into the height. What about the length? The length is a straight line, but when it was curved, the length was in the shape of a circle. The length was in the shape of a circle when it was curved. When you opened it up, it became a straight line. So this is nothing but the perimeter of the circle. Now what is the formula for perimeter of a circle? It is 2 pi r. So you can see what has happened. 2 pi r has become the length, h has become the breadth. Now area of rectangle is length into breadth. So length is 2 pi r, breadth is h. So the whole rectangle has got the area 2 pi r h. This is the curved surface area called CSA, or also called the lateral surface area, the CSA. So because it was curved, we get the formula 2 pi r h. Remember, the pi stands for the curved figure. So we have come across one more formulae. Now remember, the curved surface area of a cylinder is given as 2 pi rh, the curved surface area. So these are the formula you have to understand, you have to learn and remember. But what about the total surface area? The total surface area is the curved surface area plus the top and the bottom all together make up the total surface area. Total surface area is the curved surface area, this curved surface area, the top and the bottom. So curved surface area we have got 2 pi r h. The top is in the form of a circle given by pi r square. The bottom is in the form of a circle given by pi r square. So we get 2 pi r h plus pi r square plus pi r square is 2 pi r square. Now if you take the 2, the pi and the r common, the 2, the pi and 1 are common, we get 2 pi r into bracket h plus r. So this is the formula for the total surface area and this is the formula for the curved surface area. So today we have introduced the new object called a cylinder, which has got a curved surface area and two flat surfaces, the top and the bottom. We have now seen the formula to find out the curved surface area and total surface area of a cylinder. So if you have learned the formula and understood it very well, and if you do remember it now, we can move on to a few sums to make use of this formula. What is the question here? Find the total surface area. So see what they have asked here. Find the total surface area of the cylinders. So let us go to this cylinder 1. So what is the formula? TSA of cylinder is equal to 2 pi r into bracket h plus r. So 2 pi is 22 upon 7 into r. Now you can see this here is given as the r, the radius is 14. So r will take 14 into h. What is the height given? 8 plus, what is the r again? It is 14. So we have 7 ones are, 7 twos are. So 2 into 22 is 44, into 2 is 88. 88 into 8 plus 14 is 22. So 22 into 88 should give us the answer. Let us multiply. 88 into 22, 0, 2 8s are 16. It's a 16, 17, 1, 7, 6, 0 plus 1, 7, 6. So it is 6, 3, 9, 1. So we get the answer 1, 9, 3, 6 centimeter square. Remember you're finding the area. It is centimeter into centimeter, so centimeter square. I hope it is clear to you. Now we go to the figure 2. Again we use the same formula because we have to find the TSA. TS is equal to 2 pi r bracket h plus r, or 2 into 22 by 7 into r. Now you can see here the whole diameter. This time they have given the diameter of the circle. So you can see the placement also. Here the cylinder is in the upright position. Here the cylinder is in a side position. So do not confuse. You can see this is the height here. This is not the height. This is the height of the cylinder. While this is the diameter. Now we know the diameter is twice the radius. So if the whole diameter is 2 cm, then the radius will be half of 2. That is, the radius will be 1 cm. So we'll write radius as 1 cm into h. H is 2 meter, sorry it is meter, so 2 meter, not centimeter, meter plus r is 1 meter. So we have got 2 into 22 by 7 into 1 into 2 plus 1, that is 3. So we get 2 into 22 is 44, 44 into 3, 44 into 3 is 132, so we get 132 upon 7 meter square. Or if you want to solve it further, we can go for the decimal point. 7 ones are 7,
6 remains 62, 7, 8 are 56, 8 remains 0 point. 7 okay, this is not 62, this is 660. So 7 8 are again 56, 4 remains 40, 7 5 are 35. So it is approximately equal to 18.85 meter square. So remember this again, we had to find the total surface area of the cylinder. So we just used the formula, put down the values, did the necessary calculations and got the answer. So there are only two formulae you have to learn in the cylinder, that is the curved surface area is 2 pi rh and total surface area is 2 pi r into bracket h plus r. Okay. Now next question is given. In a building, there are 24 cylindrical pillars. 24 cylindrical pillars. The radius of the pillar is given as 28 cm. Let me write down. Radius is equal to 28 cm. The height of each pillar is 4 meter. Now, there is 1 unit in centimeter and 1 in meter. So, I'll have to change one of them. So, I'll make the 4 meter as 400 centimeter. Okay? Can I do that? Yes. Then let us read the sum fully. Find the total cost of painting the curved surface area. We have to find the curved surface area of the pillars at the rate of rupees 8 per meter square. Now, since this is given in meter square, what will I do? I will not convert the meter into centimeter. On the contrary, I will convert the centimeter into meter. So it becomes 0.28 meter. Because the sum is in meter, I convert this into meter. So one pillar is having the height 28 centimeter or 0.28 meter. Sorry, the radius and the height is 4 meter. I have to find the curved surface area of 24 cylindrical pillars. So first let me find out the CSA of one pillar. What is the formula? 2 pi rh. So we got 2 into 22 upon 7. The r is 0.28, that is 28 upon 100 into the height is 4. So 7 ones are 7, 4s are 28. So we get the area is 2 into 22 into 4 into 4 upon 100. Now that is the CSA of one pillar. We can calculate it to get the answer. 2 into 22 is, or we can do 4 4s are 16, 16 2s are 32. So 32 into 22. What do we get? 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 64, 407. So we get 704 upon 100 or 7.04 meter square is the CSA of one pillar. Now let us move to 24 pillars. So CSA, the CSA of 24 pillars will be equal to what? 7.04 into 24. So we found for one pillar, we multiply by 24. If you multiply, you will get 168.96 meter square. I hope you can do the multiplication. 704 into 24. 0 to 4 is 8, 2 0s are 0, 2 7s are 14, 4 4s are 16, carry 1, 4 0 is 16, 28. We get 69861. And the two in the digits have a decimal point, so 168.96 meter square. Now what is the cost of painting? It is rupees 8 per meter square. So cost of 1 meter square is rupees 8. Therefore, cost of 168.96 meter square will be how much? It will be 168.96 into 8. And after multiplying, you will get the answer as almost 1351 0.68 rupees. Okay, so here we have done a simple sum which is in the form of a cylinder. We found out the curved surface area of the cylinder because they have asked in the question. So read the question carefully. We found out the curved surface area of one pillar. There are in total 24 pillars, so we found out the total surface area of 24 pillars, and the cost of the painting is rupees 8 per meter square. So the total cost is 1351.68 rupees. Moving on to the next sum. Here we have find the height of the cylinder. So the height of the cylinder H is not given. We have to find H. But what are we given? Whose radius is 7 cm? The radius is 7 cm. And the total surface area, see what is mentioned. The total surface area is 968 cm square. So here we, the sum is slightly twisted, but no issue. We'll solve it using the formulae. The TSA of cylinder. This is which formula? You do remember the formula? 2 pi r into bracket h plus r. Now we are given the TSA, 968. So write down the TSA. This implies that 968, the TSA which is given to us, I put down the value of TSA equal to 2 into 22 by 7 into r. What is the radius? The radius is 7 into bracket h plus r, h plus 7. Now I cut this 7 with the 7, and what remains is 2 into 22 into h plus 7. Now since this both are in multiplication, I will first take it into the division. So 968 upon 2 into 22 gives us h plus 7. Let us do the cutting. 2 ones are 2, 4, 80, 2s are. Can we cut it further? Let us see. 2 elevens are 2, 2, 40, 1s are. Is it correct, the calculation? No. This will be 484. Yes? So, and this will be 242. Now, 11 ones are, 11 twos are 22, and 11 twos are again 22. So, we are left with 22 equal to h plus 7. So, 7 is in addition, goes in multiplication. 22 minus 7 will give us h, which implies h is equal to 15 centimeters. So this is a sort of indirect sum where the total surface area is given to us, the radius is given to us, and we are supposed to find out the height. So we use the same formula, put the values down, rearrange it, solve it, and we get the answer. In the next sum we have a closed cylindrical tank of radius 7 meter, a closed cylindrical tank of radius 7 meter and height 3 meter is made from a sheet of metal. Again we have a closed cylindrical tank of radius 7 meter and height 3 meter is made up of a sheet of metal. How much sheet of metal is required? So what is this question asking us? They have mentioned a closed cylindrical tank. Now you know we have tank of different shapes. We can have a cuboidal tank, a cubical tank, a cylindrical tank. But the tank with the word they have mentioned, your tank, is usually open from the top. And that is why this word is mentioned here, closed. Closed means it is closed from all the sides. Right? Means it has got a curved surface area, and tanks usually have a bottom. But this is a closed tank, means it is closed from the top also. So this is why you have to read the sum carefully. They have mentioned a closed cylindrical tank. Closed cylindrical tank means closed from the top also. And it is made up of metal. So what we have to find here is the TSA, the total surface area, because the tank is even closed from the top. Let us first note down, the radius is given 7 meter. The height is given 3 meter. So we have to find out the TSA. The TSA of cylindrical tank. You can recall the formula. It is 2 pi r into bracket h plus r. So we have got 2. Value of pi we put 22 by 7 into r. The radius is 7 into h, which is 3 meter, and the radius again is 7 meter. So we do the calculation, we do the cutting, the 7 and the 7 gets cut. 222s are 44 into 3 plus 7 is 10. So 40 into 10 is 440 meter square. That is the TSA of the tanks. How much metal is required to make the tank? 440 meter square of metal is required to make the tank. In the next sum, we have the lateral surface area of a hollow cylinder. What is the meaning of the word lateral surface area of hollow cylinder? Means it doesn't have a top, nor does it have a bottom. So this is a lateral surface area without a top or without the bottom. Lateral is also the curved surface area of a hollow cylinder is given 4224 centimeter square. Now it is cut along the height. So you cut it along the height and open it up. When you do that, it forms a rectangular sheet. It has formed a rectangular sheet. We have to find the perimeter of the rectangular sheet. So here you can see length is 2 pi r, the curved part, breadth is the height, right? And perimeter of the rectangular sheet is given by the formula 2 bracket L plus B. So we need to find out the L and we need to find out the B or the height. Now they have given the width is 33 centimeter. So we can take the height B as 33 centimeter. So we have to now find the length. To find the length, we need to find 2 pi r. So how will we approach the sum? We'll write down the CSA of cylinder, which is given to us. We'll take the CSA of the cylinder. What is the formula? Can you recall? 2 pi r h. Okay. It is given 4224. The CSA is given 2224. So I put it. I keep 2 pi r as it is. Why I keep the 2 pi r as it is? Because that is nothing but the length into the width, that is height, which is given 33. So 2 pi r or the length is equal to 4224 upon 33. Do the cutting and see what answer do you get. We'll first divide both of them with 3. 3 elevens are 33 and 3 ones are 12, 3 fours are 12, 0, 8. Now let us divide this by 11. So what will we get? 11, ones are 11, 3 remains 30, 11 twos are 22, 8 remains 88, 11 eights are 88. So we get 128. Now we can solve it further, but we don't need to. We'll call this the L, 128, 2 pi r is the L. So to find the perimeter, we just put the value 2 into bracket, 128 plus 33, which gives us 2, 8 plus 3 is 11, 1, carry 1, 3 plus 1, 4 into 6, and 161. 2 into 161 gives us 322. Centimeter is the perimeter. So you can see here, I could put the value of pi as 22 by 7 and find r, and after do the calculations, but I did not. Why? Because I had to find out the perimeter of the rectangular sheet. Perimeter is given by the formula 2 bracket L plus B. So I have to find out the L, which is 2 pi r, and the breadth, which is B. So B I got directly as 33, it is given 33. I found out the L using this formula, and by rearranging I got the answer. So I hope these things are now very clear to you. If not, rewind the video, watch it one more time, understand it thoroughly. I have done the solved examples for you and some sums from the exercise. What I am going to leave for the homework is question number 9 and 10 of exercise 11.3. Okay, so try out these sums and tomorrow's lecture will solve these sums. Do it in your homework book, and once we do the correction, then you can do it in the fair book. So I'm going to end the actual lecture here. Thank you.